Gurubhyo Namaha. Today we'll see the continuation of the lesson Our Earth and the Moon. Children, do you remember what we learnt in the previous videos? Now, quickly, we'll have the recap of what we learnt in those videos. First, we learnt about the formation of Earth. Then, layers of the earth. Children, do you remember what are the layers of the earth? They are the crust, mantle, and the core. Then we learnt about the beautiful moon. Then phases of the moon. Can we name the phases of the moon? New moon, crescent moon, half moon, gibbous moon, and full moon. Then we learnt about the tides, high tides, low tides, spring tides, and neap tides. Children, watch the video. Can you guess what we are going to learn today? Yes, the topic is eclipse. What are you seeing in the slide? That small girl is scared of the dark thing following her everywhere. What is the dark thing, children? Yes, it's the shadow of that girl. Now, we are going to learn about how shadows are formed. Objects around us are grouped into transparent and opaque. As you see in the transparent square, the children are visible because transparent square allows the lights to pass through it. So, the children are visible. Whereas, in the opaque square, we are not able to see the children. Now, we will see what are opaque objects. Opaque objects. An opaque object is that through which light cannot pass. So, when light falls on such an object, the path of light is obstructed and shadow is formed. Children, see this picture. What do you observe? When sunlight falls on the tree, tree being an opaque object forms the shadow by blocking the sunlight. Formation of shadows. How are shadows formed? Shadows are always formed on the opposite side of the light source. When the object is closer to the light source, it blocks more light. So, the shadow formed is bigger. As you see in the picture, you can observe the big shadow formed. When the object is far from the light source, it does not block much light. So, the shadow formed is smaller. Now, we are going to learn about eclipse. Earth and Moon are two opaque objects in space, as you see in the picture. When the light of sun falls on earth or moon, a shadow is formed on the other. So, an eclipse occurs when an object in space, such as a planet, blocks the view of another object such that it cannot be seen partially or completely. There are two types of eclipse. Solar and lunar eclipse. Now we will learn about solar eclipse. The eclipse of the sun is called a solar eclipse. It occurs on a new moon day, but not on all new moon days. Children, now we'll see how a solar eclipse occurs. A solar eclipse occurs when the sun, moon and earth are in a straight line. Can you observe this in the picture? Sun, moon and earth are in a straight line. Solar eclipse takes place when moon revolving around the earth comes between the earth and the sun. What happens now? The moon blocks the light of the sun and casts its shadow on earth. So, children, remember, always when the sun, moon and the earth are in a straight line, only solar eclipse occurs. Now, we are going to see what happens exactly during the solar eclipse. You can see that the moon coming in between and the shadow of the moon falling on the earth. This is solar eclipse. In a solar eclipse, the sun disappears and the sky appears dark for a few minutes only. Children, always remember, you should not look at a solar eclipse with naked eyes. What will happen if you do? The harmful ultraviolet rays from sun can make you blind permanently. So children, always see to it that you wear protective glasses before you view the solar eclipse. Children, now it's activity time to understand better how solar eclipse occurs. I hope everybody will be having a torch, a tennis ball, and a globe at your home. Suppose if you are not having a globe, you can even use a football as the earth. So come, we'll do the activity. Now here, the flashlight will act as the sun. So, if one person holds a flashlight and shines it onto the earth, the other person moves the small ball between the earth and the sun. Now what will happen? It will cast a shadow on earth. So, this is what happens when there is a solar eclipse. Now, we are going to see about the lunar eclipse. The eclipse of the moon is called lunar eclipse. It occurs only on a full moon day, but not on all full moon days. Come children, we'll see how it happens. A lunar eclipse occurs only when sun, earth and the moon are in the straight line. Moon revolves around the earth. Yes, at times earth comes in between sun and moon. So earth cuts off light of the sun reaching moon, and moon is completely or partially hidden under the shadow of the earth. So the people on earth cannot see it. We call this an eclipse of the moon or lunar eclipse. Children, observe the picture. You can see sun, earth and moon in a straight line. Now, here you can see what happens when the moon is revolving around the earth. The earth comes between the sun and the moon at times. So, the light is being blocked and the earth's shadow falls on the moon so that people are not able to see the moon. This is called lunar eclipse. Now, to sum up, we'll see the keywords. Transparent objects. Objects that allow light to pass through them completely are called transparent objects. For example, glass and water. Opaque objects. Objects that do not allow light to pass through them are called opaque objects. For example, bricks, wood, and stone. Lunar eclipse. When earth comes in between the sun and moon, it blocks the rays of the sun from reaching the moon. The shadow of the earth falls over the moon. Solar eclipse. When the moon comes in between the sun and the earth, it blocks the sun's rays from falling on some parts of the earth. The shadow of the moon falls on earth. So children, with this, we complete the eclipse part of the lesson. So what should you do? You have to practice drawing the diagrams of solar eclipse and lunar eclipse. Take an A4 size sheet, draw it, color it, take a pic and post it in your group. So children, we have completed the entire lesson of the our earth and the moon. So try to read the lesson and you must be able to do the book back exercises also. So children, try to do the book back exercises. With this, we complete the lesson, our earth and the moon. Thank you.